This tutorial is going to show you how to quickly edit bad sound in Premiere. Using Adobe Audition. So here we have a clip that is pretty bad in terms of sound, where it plays, and you can see here from the waveform that you can barely see any data at all. So there's a couple of things that I want to do to bring this out and make it better. You can see in other clips here. That this is what a waveform should look like, and if it's low, then it should at least look like this, where you've got little blips and then silence. Really, the problem here was a microphone problem. So, the first thing I'm going to do is to maximize this so we can see it a little better. If I play it here, there's a big buzz. But what I'm going to do is press the little Tiflis key that looks like a little squiggly line. To maximize this window, and you can press it again to remove it. You can do it with any different clip that you want to be able to see it a little larger. So I'm going to maximize this, and then if the audio was not expanded, then I would just expand it out. So I'd click on this little arrow, and then I can just drag this to make it bigger, and you can see how my waveform is really, really noisy. There's no little blips here like there are in other clips. Particularly, you can see this in the music. You can see how much variation there is. This means there's a lot of noise. So instead of trying to add a filter from Premiere, which is what you would often do, I'm going to use Adobe Audition. So I'm going to right-click on this video file, and I'm going to edit clip on Adobe Audition. This is one of the wonderful things about using the Master Suite. So in Audition, it's going to open this clip up, and you can see again, this is where the A roll, where Sarah is speaking, these little blips here, and this is just the noise behind it. It just gives me noise. What I'm going to do here is highlight a bit of that noise, and it could be in between, but when you have background noise, it's usually okay to have a clip of it from the very beginning, whether it's wind or whatever it is, but especially an air conditioner or something like that. So I'm going to highlight some, and I'm going to go to Effects. And then noise reduction restoration, noise reduction process. And it will tell you that this noise print is undefined, and that's why we highlighted a piece first. So I'm going to go to capture noise print, and then it's going to say, okay, this is what that noise sounds like. Then the thing to do is to highlight everything. So select entire file, or you can select part of the file, or whatever you want to do. So I can press Control A to select it, or I can just click on select entire file, which is what I'm doing here. And then you want to be able to reduce this noise. And the thing is, the default for some reason is ridiculously huge, 100% 40 decibels. You almost never want to do that. I'm going to bring this down to about 50, maybe even 45, and decibel reduction about 10. And we'll see how that works. You can preview it by clicking here. So this having that off will give you the regular noise. You really loud. And then if I turn it on, I can see. Problem is that when you do this, if it's too much, then you can actually remove ambient noise, which you don't want, or you can make them sound like a robot. So I'm going to actually reduce this even more, and let's see what happens. That actually sounds pretty good. So this is about where I'm going to want it. You notice that often when you have bad sound, it's often also really, really low. So what you want to make sure to do is be very careful about having something where you reduce the noise and then it's so low that you can't hear it. And that's often a very, very large problem when you're using a bad microphone. You can always amplify that back up either in Audition or in Premiere itself using the rubber band tool. But for now, this is how you do it. Good luck. Once you apply, then you can just go and save it, and it will open it or return it to Premiere. And you can see that it's automatically changed it here. One of the problems is that you can't actually go back, and unless you just undo, you can't actually go through and restore it to its original. And what it's done is it's actually altered the file itself. I mean, it hasn't actually altered the file itself. It's added a new file. So if I go into my folder here, it's put it in the same folder as my PR project, a Premiere project, and you can see it's given me a package file and a WAV file. So you want to save these because what it's doing is it's linking this clip to the other. So what I would do here is highlight these and put that into audio. You'll notice back into Premiere, it unlinks it, right? So it's going to ask you where it is. So just audio, and then it's done, then it redoes it. So this is a much, much better way to do it.